Welcome back to Seattle Center on this Monday night as we get set for preseason game number 4. We'll check out Beacon Plumbing between the pipes. Philip Grubauer will make his third start of preseason for the Kraken. He will play all 3 periods tonight. That's the plan, according to Dave Hakstol. And Jack Campbell will complete the tandem for the Edmonton Oilers. He'll be behind the Rookie of the Year finalist, Stuart Skinner. At least that's the way they expect the season to start. But a big start for him in goal. Dave Hakstol looking for another gear in the final week of preseason. Jay Woodcroft, his team is 2-2-1 in exhibition play. This is their final road encounter. Matty Beniers and Connor McDavid, the NHL's MVP on the faceoff. Sit back and enjoy this one. Cody Ceci interrupted by Seattle's Jared McCann. He'll dump it in. The Kraken are 2-0-1 with 3 games, including this one, left on the preseason slate. He'll be at Vancouver Wednesday night, in Edmonton on Friday night. Broberg, good pass for Zach Hyman. He gains the zone. He'll button hook a bit, move away from Jordan Eberle, and now Leon Draisaitl. McDavid, a shot caught by Grubauer.
Well, Grubauer had to be ready for that early. A good shot from the slot there from McDavid to the glove side. He pulls in, just changes the angle around Larson, right into that glove hand side there for Grubauer. But I like the way Evans trying to box out in front. A good start for the Seattle Kraken.
30 seconds gone, period 1. John Forslund, JT Brown, and Piper Shaw with you tonight. Matthias Janmark for the Oilers. To the point for Ben Gleason. A screenshot, and Grubauer got a piece of it. Jaden Schwartz, his preseason debut. We cataloged him in the open. The veteran Derek Ryan for the Oilers will shovel ahead. Justin Schultz is on it for Brian Dumoulin. The two guys Piper spoke about in the open tonight. Along the wall now, the Oilers trap the zone. Schultz looking over his shoulder. He'll wind it this way. Burakovsky gets back, interrupted by Dylan Holloway, who's having an outstanding camp for the Oilers. Out to center. Burakovsky will go cross corner. As the Kraken are in a partial change, Gleason will take over. Stumbling is Derek Ryan on his own accord, and it comes out to center.
Well, good backtrack there from Burakovsky. He's able to pick that puck, and Seattle goes right back into the offensive zone.
David Desharnais, 6'8", gets it out to center. James Hamblin now. They cross the line, a little dangle that time through the middle, interrupted. Good job getting back by Shane Wright, and it comes out to center ice. The Oilers now a chip by Adam Ernie. Comes all the way back in on Grubauer. He'll sling it. A pinch. Good job by Cam Dineen. He'll wedge it deeper, and Jacob Megna takes over. Played along the boards. Dumped all the way down to Jack Campbell. He can play it there in the trapezoid. For our new fans, that's the only area of the ice back at the goal line where the goaltender can handle it. Now through center. It's controlled and brought back by Adam Larson for Ryker Evans. Broken up. The Oilers transition on a change. Seth Griffith now will clear it in to an open corner. Ex-Oiler Larson in control. The big cat tries to move it. Brad Malone gets in the way. Evans overskates it. Malone gets to it. Evans will take it back, and a penalty will follow against Edmonton as Grubauer executes a change and Larson will wheel it back.
I believe it's going to be a slash on Malone. We'll double check once it gets through. But the way Evans picked his hand up when Malone was on the forecheck, you'd have to think that that's going to be a slashing call.
.24 for Edmonton has a minor penalty for high sticking.
High sticking. Take a look here. Little battle below the crease as you go through. Oh, it was the visor. That's where you saw the hand go up. I thought it was his hand, but he's going to actually readjust his visor. Official right there, easy call, see the high stick.
So the Kraken get the game's first power play. Edmonton 20th on the kill a season ago. Beniers walks it this way. Schultz across. Eberle, a miss hit off the glass in play. Beniers resets it. Justin Schultz, who started his career with Edmonton. A button hook by Beniers. He's hassled by Janmark. It goes off the stick of Matthias Janmark. It's free. Matty Beniers will get to it. The NHL's Rookie of the Year sends it in for McCann. He's occupied, and Broberg takes over. Philip Broberg can't get it out. Schultz, Eberle in the ring. He, too, a former first-round pick of the Oilers at the goal line, walked by Beniers. Awaiting here is Andre Burakovsky. He'll creep in slowly, deliberately take it back, look around, put on a bit of a show, and set up Schultz. Schultz up top, no shooting lane. Good job by Ryan. Shot taken, a save by Campbell, shoveled wide by Beniers. With a rebound opportunity, and Derek Ryan will get it out.
Seattle finally gets the puck towards the net. It's a grade A opportunity in on Campbell. But the first probably 15 or 20 seconds, they did not have close support, so it was hard to get passes through. They were having to wait and wait. Finally, they were able to make a lane available for Schultz to be able to take that shot.
Now Riker Evans moves it across for Andrew Podorolski. He'll take it in to the goal line by Kyler Yamamoto. A partial freeze. Campbell seeking that puck. He's got it. He'll melt it down. 36 seconds left in the power play.
Get a look at this opportunity here. Schultz just fires a wrister, getting it towards the net. You have Matty Beniers out in front. He does get his stick on that. Campbell's able to make the save and push that puck wide. But a good opportunity with Matty Beniers standing out in front.
Be high emotions tonight for Kyler Yamamoto, who was let go by Edmonton. He was a first-round pick a few years back. Looking for a job here with the Kraken. He's had a good camp. Desharnais rims it. It goes by Alex Wenberg and all the way back down. So final push for the Kraken. 25 seconds or so left on the power play as time has stopped on the big board. The Twins are frozen here at Climate Pledge Arena. Broken up by Edmonton's Dylan Holloway. Evans will get back. Riker Evans marks him well. It's shoved in by Holloway. Grubauer, two saves with Adam Ernie knocking on the door.
Good hustle to get back in on the play. The kickout did not work for Seattle on the power play. You're going to see Yamamoto at the blue line. Tried to kick that out over to Wenberg, but it's Riker Evans on the back track. Playing the man, not allowing both the man and puck to get past him, and Grubauer is able to shut that play down.
So as they figure out the two beautiful scoreboards here at Climate Pledge Arena, 3 seconds remain on the penalty to Brad Malone.
Take a look here at Evans, just boxing out Holloway, not allowing him to get through. Grubauer going for the poke. A great play there by Holloway, though. Diving effort, just trying to get that puck towards the net. Evans right on that line, I would say, for borderline interference, not allowing him to skate past that to go get the puck and be in that area. But I think it's a good defensive play. But you're bordering, you're right on that edge whether or not they can call a penalty on that play.
Still some discussion in terms of the clock. They sort it out now. 6 seconds on the board, 15:33 left in period one. The Kraken have two shots on this power play. McDavid out to draw. Faceoff won by Seattle. Shane Wright refines the handle. Now Adam Larson goes cross ice. Brian Dumoulin tipped along by Wright. Broberg had it. He lost it. Ex-Oiler Devin Shore in the slot. Chipped wide by Ty Cartier. Right to the corner. Cartier will cycle out. Little handoff is broken up by Dreisaitl. Broberg, his option. To the corner, Phil Kemp. And now Cartier with good hustle got across there. 52 in deep sea blue. And now Larson walks in for a shot off the goal post. The near post. And it stays in play. McDavid out to center. We'll drop it off for Leon Dreisaitl. Broken up. Ty Cartier has it for the Kraken. He'll feed it in.
Well, what a good look there. I thought for a second that Wright maybe had the time to turn and take a shot, but he ends up finding Larson. Larson ends up getting a grade A opportunity off the post.
Connor McDavid off the side of the goal, paddle down for Grubauer, no further play.
Here's this opportunity. Shane Wright sends it over to Larson. He picks his head up, waits for players to get closer to the front of the net. He does beat Campbell, not able to beat the post here. Right off the bar and out.
James Hamblin out to take the draw here for Edmonton, opposed by Matty Beniers. Resituate this draw. 4 shots in the game, 3 taken by the Oilers. That may be another inconsistency. We had 2 shots previously announced in terms of the Kraken power play. We'll get it right by the end of the night. 14:22 left in period one. Goalless start. here at beautiful Climate Pledge Arena, final home game in preseason for the Kraken. It's cleared out to center. Cody Ceci, the inside track on Jared McCann. Philip Broberg plays it along the wall. Hamblin had it. He lost it. Broberg hassled by Beniers. Eberle. Beniers locates it now. He'll get to it. He'll cycle out. Awaiting is Jordan Eberle. He'll grind a cycle. He goes high with it. Oleksiak, it's tipped. Blocked by Broberg. And the Oilers will fish it back out to center ice. 13:45 left here in period one. Medna. Good first pass for Andre Burakovsky. Nice retrieval by Alex Wenberg. A stutter step. He'll rim it this way for Justin Schultz. He'll play it along for Jaden Schwartz. He'll turn, front the play. Blocked in front by Ben Gleason. Former member of the Dallas Stars organization. Gleason on the off wing. A shot. Stopped by Grubauer. They score on the rebound. Xavier Bourgault gets to it. Former first round pick. 13:22 left in period one. The Oilers strike first.
Well, an offensive opportunity here. Schwartz trying to find Burakovsky, going to that back post, but that leads a 3-on-2 break. Right off the blocker, Bourgault out in front, unchecked, is able to get his backhand on this and shovel it into the empty net. How quickly an offensive opportunity on one side doesn't get through. That's one thing the Oilers have on this team, is that quick strike ability.
Xavier Bourgault played 62 games in the American Hockey League last season. And as we pointed out, a former first round pick with a bright future. And when you're playing this late in preseason as a young player, that's a good sign. Just about 7 minutes gone in period one. Yamamoto takes it back. Spokane native out to center. We have two of those in the game tonight. He and Derek Ryan of Edmonton. It's games wide. Larson's heavy shot gloved by Jack Campbell. We get a stoppage of play. 12:58 left to go in the opening period. The Kraken had a power play early that was unsuccessful. Xavier Bourgault has scored for the Oilers. They have an early 1-0 lead.
They're not playing bad. I wouldn't say, you look at the opportunities that Edmonton's been able to get, really the one they scored on has been the best opportunity besides the shot McDavid had 30 seconds into the game. You got a couple good looks on the power play. Grubauer is finally getting, you know, that first full game. He's going to get that timing back as well. Like to see off the blocker, maybe have a little bit better rebound control, but overall, not so bad of a start.
A headhunter by Matty Beniers goes off the end glass. Dreisaitl will take over. He's off the side of the goal. Beniers out in front. Good job. Dreisaitl and Desharnais getting there for Edmonton. Out to center. Taken down with Zach Hyman. And they play on. Just a collision between he and Adam Larson. Beniers now rights the ship. Fans on a pass. Then he says, I'll do it myself. He'll get it out. Indirect pass for Eberle, who pitches in. Desharnais back on it. All the way around for Leon Dreisaitl. What a playoff he had a season ago. McDavid on the gallop. Going wide, a shot blocked, rubbed out beautifully by Adam Larson. Beniers back out, losing control. Phil Kemp will take over. He'll take it back. Just about 8 minutes gone in the opening period. 8 shots in the game, 5 taken by the Oilers. Edmonton ousted in 6 in the second round by the eventual Stanley Cup champion Vegas Golden Knights. John Hayden, Andrew Podorolski, kicked out with a purpose by Campbell. Along the boards now, Devin Shore is tied up. Derek Ryan in the skates of Dylan Holloway. He'll feed it in. Megna back on it. He's paired on defense tonight with Cale Fleury. Good forechecking by the Oilers. Holloway supported by Ryan. This is Broberg at the point. He'll feed it in over the stick of Holloway. Collected by Janmark. Up top it goes. Cody Ceci. This way for Philip Broberg. Broberg drifting one to the line. Cut off by Cale Fleury. Then he turns it over to Derek Ryan, who turns it over to Fleury. And then it's pitched out to center by John Hayden. So the Oilers now can reset. And Seattle and Edmonton both will change. Philip Broberg, he too a first round pick, out to center ice. Goes by Adam Ernie all the way down. Good hustle. Hamblin got there. Raphael Lavoie out of the corner, tied up. Hamblin now feeds it in. Dumoulin on his horse for Seattle. He'll move it. Burakovsky strong on the wall in the skates of Wenberg, and now collected by Justin Schultz. Here come the Kraken. Schultz off a stick off Broberg, back out to center. It deflects off young Lavoie. And it's sent out to center by Grubauer. David Desharnais was not scheduled to play tonight. Brett Kulak, a veteran, was, so Desharnais was a late add-on during the warm-up. Brad Malone sends it all the way around. Shane Wright, a give back. Riker Evans is handcuffed by that. He's tied up by Xavier Borgo. Back to the point. Desharnais, and now Gleason with a shot. Good block by Yamamoto. The Oilers get to it again. Desharnais spins it off the backside of Shane Wright. And the Kraken are back out. Yamamoto tries to recapture the puck. Gleason lays it off the window and gets it out. Adam Larson, the quick up. Yamamoto for Shane Wright. Mishandling a bit. Ty Cartier, Yamamoto circles with it. Looks around. He gets it back to the ring right. A shot caught by Jack Campbell. Good shot by the youngster, 19 years of age, Shane Wright. 9:45 left in the opening period, 1-0, Edmonton.
Into your partner, block shot, and Seattle goes out the other way.
Great opportunity for Evans to play in concert with Adam Larson tonight. Vince Dunn has been sidelined the last couple of days, termed as a maintenance situation by Dave Hakstol. We might get a further update tomorrow, we'll see. Along the boards now, McDavid, forechecked by Eberle, who steals it. Played off a stick, it went off Dineen, and now a pinch by Megna. Goes high and out of play. Stopping action here. Nice catch along the far side. 9:31 left, period one.
That's why you always got to be paying attention. Puck can go out. I'm still waiting to catch one as I'm in between the benches. It's been close.
I haven't actually caught it yet, though. Worry about you down there. I know you're quick, you're still agile, you're really young still. As opposed to me, anybody is. Out to center now, played off the boards and out. McCann pestered by McDavid. Hyman had it, lost it, now Beniers is back on it. 1-0 Edmonton on a goal by Xavier Borgo. McDavid sends it back. The Oilers now out to center, Dreisaitl. Swooping across, Connor McDavid, 1-on-3. Joined by Hyman now. McDavid to the point man, Cam Dineen. To play it deep by McDavid. Here's Dreisaitl out of the corner. McDavid in control to the slot, interrupted. Dreisaitl taken down, canceled by Megna. And the Kraken will survive that. Seattle dumps it off the curved glass along the far side at the Oiler bench for a break and play.
Well, big time save there by... Is it their backup goalie, Pickard?
Yeah.
Sitting there on the side. That puck came in pretty fast. He's able to get a glove on it. That's twice in a row. Again, you have to pay attention. But I really like that play from Megna. Tough to play defense against those guys, McDavid and Dreisaitl. But the best way, use that size, that 6'6" frame. Knock them on their backside. They can't play offense that way.
Calvin Pickard is a former Seattle Thunderbird. 31-year-old veteran goaltender, backup goaltender tonight, at least to start the game. Campbell in on it. Play it to the outside. Cody Ceci, glove down by Brian Dumoulin, hit hard by Derek Ryan. Now Jaden Schwartz grinding along the board, stopping and starting on Broberg. Here's Burakovsky. He's tied up by Ryan. Burakovsky held. A penalty against Edmonton, their second. Delayed whistle. Here's Schultz. Here it comes, just wide. It ricochets out of play. And the Kraken go back a man up.
It's going to be an easy call for the officials. Good shot here on the delayed penalty.
Number 10 for Edmonton has a minor penalty for holding.
But it'd be the using of the free arm getting around, wrapped around Burakovsky before that shot by Schultz, drawing the penalty. Get a good opportunity with Jaden Schwartz out in front trying to get a tip. Here's a look at the penalty. You get your arm wrapped around, holding him up against the wall like that. Pretty easy one for the official standing right there. And you're back on the power play.
Second power play for Seattle. Two shots with their first. And the Oilers dump it out early. The power play for Dave Hakstol. There's the quarterback, Justin Schultz, of this first unit, joined by Jordan Eberle, who has the puck now. Andre Burakovsky, Matty Beniers, and Jared McCann. Nice play by James Hamblin. He'll clear it all the way back down. Schultz back on it. 90 seconds on the Kraken power play. Eberle will gain the zone, defer to himself out of the corner. Defensively marked by CeCe Broberg along the boards and out. More time killed. Kraken down to 70 seconds on this power play. Schultz will slingshot it back for Kyler Yamamoto. He'll sweep it across. Wenberg, look it over. Bumped out by Schwartz, Evans, and now Podorolski. A shot swallowed up without rebound by Campbell.
Well, finally a good zone entry by Seattle. They're able to gain the control. Evans straight over to Podorolski, but I'd like to see Yamamoto stand in front. Stay, he's drifting away. Take those eyes away. You get a better look on this side. He's in front, moves off to the side, maybe looking for a pop play, but when Podorolski's getting ready to shoot, you see him with that puck ready. Stand in front, take away the goaltender's eyes.
Shot number one on the power play for the Kraken. Schwartz digs it out. Here's Riker Evans to the wall. Podorolski downhill. He'll send it back out of the reach of Evans and a reset. As the Kraken get back on side with 39 seconds left in this power play. Wenberg will feed it in. Yamamoto perseveres hard on Kemp. They jam along the boards. Gleason moves it for the Oilers, not out. Evans a good keep. Top of the ring, Podorolski chipped in. There it is, Kyler Yamamoto. And Schwartz got a stick to it. And Yamamoto made sure. It's a power play goal, and the Kraken have tied it.
Well, good puck movement on this power play. Evans going to walk to the middle. Podorolski, a little shot tip in on Schwartz. See Yamamoto off to the side, able to push that puck in. Don't know if that puck's for sure going in, but it is for sure when Yamamoto does take this puck. Right there, gets a stick on it, but I like the puck movement. I like Evans walking the line. Good shot tip in front. I got a lot of good looks from the power play here, not only on this one, but the last one as well.
For Kyler Yamamoto, it will be his third goal of preseason. He scored two goals in Calgary, both on the power play on night number one on that split squad day. He played for the team that went to the Saddle Dome. Broberg shot wide through a screen. Zach Hyman out in front. Dumoulin sends it back, and he's hit hard. Brian Dumoulin finished off in a hard way by Leon Draisaitl, and the Oilers will be penalized again. Right, delayed whistle, Burakovsky, and now Cartier zings it wide. Larson, six skaters out for the Kraken. Andre Burakovsky ambles in, takes it to the corner by right, hailed in by Larson. This way it's Devin Shore, through the slot right, had it, lost it, touched up. Now by Broberg. So Kyler Yamamoto, the Spokane native, against his former team. What a great feel. Minor penalty, as JT pointed out. Third power play for Seattle. Kyler Yamamoto has just tied the game with a power play strike. Schultz walks the line. Here's Jordan Eberle to the goal line for Beniers. Matty Beniers this way for Burakovsky. He'll take it in. Draw defender in Derek Ryan. Nice pass for McCann, and now Schultz. To the wall, Burakovsky zinging it off Eberle. Defensively marked by Desharnais, who tried to get it out. Ryan now will, with 1:35 left in the power play.
This top unit so far, obviously it's still preseason for everybody, but I'd like to see a little bit better support. They're not able to use that middle bumper as much as you'd like to break some of this pressure from Edmonton.
Burakovsky gains entry. Knocked down by Beniers. He'll take it to the boards. He's tied up. It's a four-man scrum. James Hamblin now will get it out. Kraken's power play 21st in the NHL a season ago. McCann will send it back for Riker Evans. And the second unit comes out for Dave Hakstol. No shots so far. Yamamoto steams through the middle. Options out for Wenberg. He throws a little snow. He's marked by two. One of those is CeCe. Schwartz broken up. Adam Ernie out to center ice. He'll feed it in on Philip Grubauer. Edmonton changing the penalty killers as Evans brings it forward. He'll send it back for Yamamoto. 35 seconds left in the manpower advantage. Here's Podorolski. Sending it back for Riker Evans. Podorowski from the boards. Thinks twice. Riker Evans. Podorowski again. Good read by Borgo. Two on one, shorthanded. Derek Ryan will get to it. Xavier Borgo has the Oilers' goal, has the puck. He's pinned and knocked down by Wenberg. The puck is underneath young Borgo. Trust me, it is. Maybe it's caught. It is in his equipment. So they stop play.
I'd like to see Podorowski shoot that puck. He tried to go with the seam pass. That created the opportunity for Edmonton going back with Borgo. If it's not broke, don't fix it. They're able to score on a shooting play from Podorowski. I'd like to see him do it again. We take another look here. Good check in physical by Wenberg. They're trying to find that puck. It's always funny. You never know where it is when you're on the ice. You're always looking for it. Yeah. You never know when it's going to drop. You just hope it's not you, the one that has the puck in your wardrobe.
I hate that myself. Now Dumoulin out to center ice. And Desharnais out of the corner. Checked by Cartier. John Hayden to the point. Dumoulin rubbed out by Zach Hyman. He checks out his stick. It's okay. And he'll get it out to center ice. So the penalty has concluded. Even terms on the ice, even terms on the board. 3:14 left, period one. Connor McDavid out to center ice for Leon Draisaitl. Cut off by Dumoulin, regained by Gleason. Cartier gets to it, back out to center. The Oilers now reorganize. Leon Draisaitl. McDavid in full flight to the outside of Dumoulin, by him and in. Off sticks off Larson with Grubauer down and out. As McDavid took it to the house. Broberg, McDavid wants more. He'll pull up. Draisaitl from the wall. It's a spindling puck settled down by Larson, but a giveaway. McDavid off the back of the goal. It's covered by Grubauer. No further play. Let's go down to Piper Shaw.
Thank you, John. Well, like you guys mentioned earlier, Kyler was a first-round pick of the Oilers in 2017. He spent pretty much his whole, well, he did spend his whole NHL playing career with that organization. And this morning he said it's going to be kind of odd playing against the team because it's not something he'd experienced before. But he had a little smirk on his face while he said that as well. And I think that smirk made a little bit of sense on that power play there, guys.
No doubt about it. Broberg moved in. Megna now in control off the boards and out. 2:20 left, period one. 8 shots taken by the Kraken. They have had 3 power plays. Edmonton with 5 shots. Now Lavoie will get it in. Picked up, dumped out to center. Dineen goes across. Kemp sends it all the way around. Here's Seth Griffith sidestepping Cale Fleury. They jam along the boards. Dineen, now Kemp. Off the boards intentionally, gained by Fleury. An angled pass does not get out. Griffith is given a shove. Beniers takes over. Some sloppy play, but the Kraken get it out. John Hayden will feed it in. Cam Dineen to the corner. It was off a stick on the way out from Dylan Holloway with 1:38 left in the first.
It can get sloppy around this time late in the period. Ice may not be in the best conditions. That's why it's most important right in front of your blue line. You got to get those pucks out. Eventually, they were able to do it. You'd like to see it, though, happen on that first time. Even if it goes for an ice and you can reset late in the period, you got to make sure those danger zones, you take care of it.
Dave Hakstol will send out the Wenberg line. Wenberg, Schwartz, and Burakovsky. Dumoulin and Schultz are back. Derek Ryan's an excellent faceoff artist. He's out there, number 10 in the white sweater for Edmonton. And Seattle gets possession. Dumoulin, good read by Ryan. He'll get it out. Janmark, broken up. Wenberg, hassled by Janmark. Puck is free. Ryan moves it out of the reach of Desharnais. 1:20 left in period one. John, JT, and Piper, along with our great crew here at Climate Pledge Arena. Wenberg all the way back. Schultz settled up by Janmark. Jaden Schwartz grinds a cycle. Goes off the stick of Janmark and again out to center. We approach the 19-minute mark in period one. Through center, Andrei Burakovsky sealed off by Lavoie. They go to the boards. Schwartz will go deep. Hamlin in control. Stretch pass. Raphael Lavoie moves in. Canceled by Larson easily. The puck is frozen now by Grubauer.
Well, just excellent defense there by Larson. Schultz goes for the change. You think there's a little bit of room for Lavoie, but nope. Cancels him out. Good stick out. Grubauer, easy cover there. I think they wanted him to play it, but a great, smart play by him. Take it down. Don't put Riker Evans in a bad opportunity shoving that puck out.
Good stuff. Evans now through center. Off the stick of Hayden. Wedged along CeCe. Hamblin moves in. Shoots it from well out. Wide of Grubauer. 28 seconds left in the period. Seattle back out through center. Lavoie left it there. Bourgault broken up. Hayden will kick it in the zone. Broberg is back on it with his head on a swivel. He's tied up by Devin Shore, who played over 40 games as an Oiler a season ago. Goes by Lavoie, back out through center. 7 seconds left in the first period. Larson's on the spot. Adam takes it back, and wide open is Riker Evans. That'll do it. So the teams trade goals, and Kyler Yamamoto has a power play strike for the Kraken. And he'll talk it over with Piper Shaw on the other side of this.
That's the hard part. You cannot keep them off the board. But when they get these opportunities, McDavid, head of steam, Riker Evans does a great job keeping his gap, forcing him into his partner. You look at another opportunity. McDavid going through the middle. Dumoulin one-on-one again, forcing into the partner. Runs into Grubauer there. But again, you're cutting off their time and space. Lavoie thinks he has a little bit more time than he does. And again, Larson making an easy save for Grubauer. Again, you have to be able to defend in layers against a team like this.
I'm not big on stats in the regular season. I don't know how I feel about preseason stats, but there they are. So digest those numbers, everybody, as we get set for the second period. So both goals tonight, a youngster scoring for the Edmonton Oilers, Xavier Bourgault.
Well, rush one way, turns into an odd man for Edmonton going back off the blocker, and Bourgault is able to find a little bit of open space right out in front of Philip Grubauer. Here's the power play strike, a nice shot pass into the middle, and it's Yamamoto right at the goal line, able to put that one just past.
As we take a look at the Emerald Queen Casino scoring summary, the two goals tonight. They've added an assist, Andrew Podorolski, along with Jaden Schwartz, on the goal scored by that guy, Kyler Yamamoto. He has 3 goals in preseason, looking for a role and a needed role when you look at the fourth line and what it did last season for the Kraken.
When you look at some of those guys that have left, there's a lot of production that needs to be replaced, and that can be from the top line all the way down to the fourth line. You bring in a guy like Yamamoto who has that talent, he has the ability to be able to give you some of that depth production that they lost when you look at the guys like Geeky is gone. Ryan Donato is no longer here. Sprong, who also had a great season last year. Those are some big numbers you have to fill all the way up and down your lineup, but that's one thing Seattle's always been able to do is score through their depth.
John Forsland, JT Brown, Piper Shaw, supported by our great team of professionals here on Root Sports. Second period of the long change as we started period one. It's Connor McDavid of Edmonton, Matty Beniers for the Kraken on the draw. And the puck comes all the way down to Philip Grubauer, who is scheduled to go the distance in this game tonight as that one deflects out of play. 9 seconds gone. The Kraken will be in Abbotsford, British Columbia, minor league home, American Hockey League home of the Vancouver Canucks on Wednesday night. And against these Oilers in Edmonton on Friday night. We'll be on Kong for that one Friday night from Alberta. Broberg, CeCe. Now McDavid, a handoff for Dreisaitl. Skate to stick retrieval. He refines the handle out of the corner, marked by Riker Evans. Zach Hyman is there for the Oilers. CeCe moves it across for Broberg. Diagonal pass off the glove hand, the left hand of Beniers. Now Dreisaitl. Move back for CeCe. He'll settle it. Broberg goes wide off the wall. McDavid knocks it out of midair, then it's baseball batted right out of play. Delay of game against the Kraken. Scrambled out in front. So Edmonton, who had the best power play in the world last season, We'll go at it here.
Number 10 for Seattle has a minor penalty for delaying the game.
Well, McDavid right there basically baited Seattle into this penalty, just flipping and trying to flip it up onto the back of the net, getting it over the top. And when it does go up, it ends up being Riker Evans in the box right now, who hits the puck up and over for the delay of game.
The Oilers power play clicked at 32.4% last season. So they get Beniers. Evans was there too. Beniers only took one penalty a season ago. The pickup by our producer, Ryan Schaber. So he is, albeit preseason, he'll still have a clean slate, believe it or not, next week. Draisaitl in control. The regular season starts in Vegas on Tuesday night of next week. Draisaitl right across McDavid. Draisaitl off the mark. The puck was on edge. It goes by Gleason and all the way back. Wennberg, Cartier, Dumoulin, and Megna are the quartet of killers for Dave Hextall. Leon Draisaitl. Here comes the captain, Connor McDavid. He'll cut across, lay it along for Dylan Holloway. He'll play it off a stick. It ricochets, collected by Draisaitl. A fancy Dan pass broken up, and Beniers is out. So Beniers was asked out of the box, and it is Evans who went in. So Beniers is clean in terms of penalties. That's good news. Out through center ice. McDavid goes wide of Fleury. Larson plays it well. McDavid gets it back. It's held in by Ben Gleason. Here's Leon Draisaitl. 50 seconds on the power play. McDavid in front. Holloway knocked down. Double teamed. It's loose there for the taking. Little hack and whack time. And Larson has it. Two on one. Shorthanded with McCann. Larson delays. He gets it back. It's blocked on the way back by Zach Hyman. 30 seconds on the manpower advantage. McDavid pulls up on Cartier. Went off Fleury. Now a foot race, and Draisaitl has the inside track on Ty Cartier. He's got it. Final push for the Oilers on this power play. Draisaitl through center. Borgeau at the line, muscled by Megna. Borgeau sends it back. This is Broberg away from Cartier, who heads off on a change. No shots in the power play. As Evans is out, Broberg will dump it in. Dumoulin, Broberg losing his stick. Yamamoto through center. Borgeau all over him. Riker Evans will cushion deep and go off on a change. Hamlin in control, reverses for Cody Ceci. And the veteran now plays it away from the forechecking of Yamamoto. Right off the paddle of Jack Campbell. Shane Wright with a coy backhander. Now Hamlin will get it out. Fielded by Schultz. Justin Schultz tied up by James Hamlin. And now in control, Brian Dumoulin. Here's Yamamoto. Kyler moves it along the dasher deep. Desharnais back first. Hit by Devin Shore. They jam for it. Shore goes wide, plays it off a stick, defensive stick by Lavoie, and it comes out.
Yeah, sometimes that crossing, you don't have to force that play. You'd like to see it throw that back down, get the offense going, especially after a long penalty kill.
Adam Ernie plays it back. Ernie played in Detroit last season and a few seasons with the Tampa Bay organization and was a teammate of yours at one point through center. Odorowski tied up Desharnais. Transition time for the Oilers. Matthias Janmark in the off wing cuts across. Good bat checking by Schwartz. And now Ernie out of the corner drops it off. Here's Derek Ryan. Up top, Phil Kemp going wide. Dineen with a shot blocked in front by Evans. Odorowski through center, four abreast. Come the Kraken. Burakovsky cuts. Creates space. And button hooks away from Janmark. Shot taken by Megna, knocked down in front by Cam Dineen, and now Adam Ernie is back out. He'll go off on a change. 15:30 left in the second period. John, JT, and Piper here at beautiful Climate Pledge Arena. Final home game of preseason. Megna, Beniers hits a seam, lays it off for Eberle. A shot ricochets off Campbell and goes out of play.
Want to go back to the penalty kill for Seattle. Right here is Fleury. Tough job out in front. Best power play in the world. You see McDavid going through. Great play. takes the stick, blocks the puck out. This leads to a two-on-one opportunity, a mad scramble out in front. Fleury's got to take two players out in front. He's able to block the puck. Two-on-one going the other way for a shorthanded opportunity.
Veneers wins the draw. Megna shoots it wide of Campbell. McCann was cruising out in front. Veneers hustles in. Good play, Eberle. McCann plays it well. Veneers in tight. Occupied by Griffith. A good stick check. Edmonton survives. They get it out. Malone. Seth Griffith. He'll go wide of Megna, who marks it well. Leaves it there, though. Out in front just by Borgo. Flung by Malone. Borgo was by Griffith, and now getting to it is Cale Fleury with space. Through center, he headmans the puck to Matty Beniers. Beniers pulls up on Cody Ceci. McCann down low. Eberle, a tight shut down. Good save by Campbell.
A couple of good plays here leading to this shot on net. Beniers is able to draw Ceci in to McCann. McCann with a nice low read, trying to find Eberle. He wants to elevate that puck just a little bit more. Campbell hugging that near side post. But again, good patience by Beniers to find McCann, and then again finding Eberle right out at the dot lane.
Wenberg's line comes out. This Troika's Wenberg, Schwartz, Burakovsky for Seattle. McDavid is out there. Two big boys, McDavid, Dreisaitl. Shot taken, blocked at the D from Burakovsky. So it's McDavid, Dreisaitl, and Hyman for Edmonton. Dumoulin holding on to it. Swung across, Schultz. Curling out is Burakovsky. He'll shoot it. Blocker save Campbell. Good rebound control. And the Oilers get it out. Dreisaitl cut off momentarily by Burakovsky. McDavid, Leon Dreisaitl. McDavid lurking. He'll take it back. Connor McDavid stops on a dime. Sets up Dreisaitl. Off the stick of Dumoulin. Dreisaitl gets it back. Awaiting is David Desharnais. He'll move it across for Ben Gleason. A little cut by Dreisaitl. A good one. He goes down. Paddle down Grubauer. Seattle attempting to survive it. It's held in by McDavid. Dreisaitl out of the corner. Stood up by Schultz, supported by Wenberg, who sidesteps McDavid. And Schwartz is out through center ice. Jaden Schwartz now, as the rest of his teammates were hailing a cab on a change. They'll just keep it deep. Gleason through center. Here comes Janmark. Defensively marked by Riker Evans. Good play. They battle along the boards now. 13:25 left in the second period. Tied at one. Yamamoto digs it out. He has Seattle's goal. Kyler Yamamoto through center. Tough pass for Ty Cartier. Back on it, Phil Kemp. Forechecked by Cartier. Janmark gets help from Holloway. They get it out. Here they come. They are the Oilers. Ryan Holloway poked wide with Grubauer. Down and out. Dineen in control, back out. Pastored by Cartier, who has it. Ty Cartier in the off wing. Curls. He's checked by Dylan Holloway, and it comes out to center. 12:49 left here in the second period. Micah Evans. D to D passing with Larson. This is Devin Shore. The veteran moves in. He'll go wide. Stop. Throw a little snow. Broken up by Adam Ernie. Ernie out to center. A native of New Haven, Connecticut. He'll clear it in to the corner. The Oilers get to it. Lavoie in back of the goal to the outside. Raphael Lavoie up top. Broberg in the skates of Cody Ceci. He'll move it deep by Megna, who knocks it out of midair. Hamlin leaves it there. And now Lavoie. A reverse hit on Megna. Podorowski sets up Hayden, and the Kraken get it out. Devin Shore will feed it in. Broberg. Read by Shore. He sealed the wall. Dumoulin shot fought off and covered by Jack Campbell. A heavy shot by Brian Dumoulin. 12:01 left to go in the second period at the age of 21. What an experience. What an opportunity for Riker Evans, who's holding up his end of the bargain. Folks, but JT had established a great relationship. I've had a tough time over the years with mascots, but not with Bowie.
Well, now it's like you guys are best friends.
I know. I actually had a tough time in the minor leagues with a mascot.
Not only the minor leagues.
In Sherbrooke, Quebec. That's right. Other places, too. I can be grumpy at times, but not on this note. Also, happy birthday to our great director, Pat Brown. We believe it's a milestone today. We're not sure. We're researching all of this, but Happy birthday, Pat, and hope you get to work again. Now Dumoulin in control. Move back. He works on daily contracts. Dumoulin to the wall. McCann holding on to it. Through the slot. Good stick. Janmark right on. And Campbell recovered as the Kraken come calling. 11:20 left in the second period. Dumoulin out of the reach of Eberle, all the way back in, icing against Seattle.
What an opportunity for Schultz, activating from the defense. McCann fires it over. It does go off Janmark's stick, but I believe that helps get right onto the stick of Schultz. Get a good look here, slows it down right onto the tape. Rolling puck, right pad saved by Campbell, and a good one that was.
Campbell was the number one. Stuart Skinner was a great story last year. Kept with a shot at Skane, the outside of the goalpost. Near post to Grubauer. Out of the corner now. McDavid darts. His pass in the skates of Hyman. Look out here. Dineen, he'll dust it off. Now Dreisaitl, he'll dangle in. Connor McDavid at the half wall. This way for Cam Dineen. Dineen now guarded by Schwartz. McDavid out of the corner. Dineen with a shot wide. It ricochets back. And it's played here by Seattle's Jaden Schwartz. He'll get it out. He'll move up on Kemp. Dineen cut across. Dreisaitl looks for a friend. That's the best one. McDavid, he'll stop. Look around. On a change, CeCe will hunt it down. Let go by Hyman for Dreisaitl. Here's McDavid to the slot. Let go again by Hyman, flung out by Schwartz. The Kraken survived that one. And we have a penalty called in back of the play. It's a hooking call. 10:22 left in the second period. And Seattle's Cale Fleury will take a seat.
27 for Seattle has a minor penalty for hooking.
Well, here's a big kill for Seattle. Another look. Right out in front, you're going to see Fleury goes through. It's not a whole lot out in front, but again, you have one of the best power plays. Again, can't go off it directly last year, but you got to assume they're going to be at the top of the league again when it comes to those power play numbers with the talent that they have.
Faceoff is fought for, kicked out by McDavid. Back it goes, Cam Dineen. McDavid saddled up beautifully by Larson. Shorthanded come the Kraken. Wenberg over the line. The trailer is Dumoulin. He's in. The pass out of the reach of Cartier. Fed along by Larson. A good sequence there that kills about 25 seconds. Edmonton now their second power play tonight. Cam Dineen for McDavid. They move it to the outside. Dylan Holloway, McDavid to an open flank. Awaiting is Dreisaitl. Leon Dreisaitl lays it back to the point man, Cam Dineen. And now McDavid. Dineen, center point. McDavid to the outside. Good read by McCann. McCracken with help from Beniers. Get it out. Beniers steams in shorthanded. Stop the rebound. Sent high. Beniers taken down by Dineen. McCracken have killed the front end of the power play. Here comes Dreisaitl. McDavid all the way across. A centering pass by Holloway, interrupted by Devin Shore, and out she goes.
Good effort out in front. Got McDavid attempting that wraparound, trying to find somebody out in the slot, but you have everybody packed into the house there, all four players, and that puck's able to get cleared down the ice.
No shots on the power play as of yet. Yamamoto, a good play, a steal from young Borgo, and it comes down. 27 seconds on this power play. Nice look at Ben Gleason. Cousin Tim is assistant coach with Carolina. Longtime NHL defenseman. Out of the corner now. Yamamoto will get to it. He'll wheel out with 13 seconds left in the Kraken kill. This is Cartier with a shot off a body off Broberg. Yamamoto drops it off. Cale Fleury is up and ready. 3 seconds left on his penalty. And now Ben Gleason off a stick off Cartier. The Kraken kill it again. Ty Cartier, Fleury for the front. Here he is, shut down by Campbell. Jack Campbell on his game. It comes out to center. All the way down to Philip Grubauer.
Great feed by Cartier. Again, Fleury driving the post. Just gets around the outstretched defenseman laying down, and he's able to put that pass right on the tape of Fleury.
Riker Evans now will send it in. To the corner, good hustle on a change by Andre Burakovsky, supported by Shane Wright. Interference on the referee. That's not a penalty as Ryan went down. It comes out to center. Now Ernie this way for CeCe, but the Oilers are offside. It was Derek Ryan. 7:43 left to go in the middle session here in Seattle. Matty Beniers shorthanded. Jack Campbell comes up big. Then Cartier, a dandy of a pass to Cale Fleury, and Campbell is a big story in goal.
Not every time do you have to beat that first player. Sometimes you can just push that puck down and get it below the goal line.
John, JT, and Piper near a Climate Pledge Arena. Final home game of preseason. Kraken 2-0-1. The Oilers are 2-2-1. Played along the boards now. Dumoulin will get to it. He'll take it back. In his first season as a Kraken, Brian sends it in. Schultz, the shin guards of Hayden, and now Dumoulin pinches. John Hayden out of the corner, tugged a bit. They play on. John Hayden displays his strength. It gets out, though. Adam Ernie, good stick by Schultz. Counterattack Kraken. Podorolski goes wide. He'll circle the wagons, maintain control. Andrew Podorolski is tied up by Cam Dineen momentarily now. Megna, a shot through a screen wide. In play, Cale Fleury will settle it down. Spin off Brad Malone. Now Dineen handcuffed by forechecking pressure. Loose at the side of the goal. Good play by Podorolski. Megna cruising. Podorolski again. A stinger blocked. Good block by Phil Kemp. Loose along the boards now. It pinballs back to Megna through a screen block by Dineen. Left there for the taking and shoveled out by Adam Ernie.
Well, Dineen had a great stick there. Burakovsky's trying to toe drag that puck on his forehand. He's going to have a real good look in on Campbell, but a solid stick check out right out in front.
To the boards now. Holloway back out. Hamblin shoved in the zone by Adam Ernie. Icing Edmonton, 6:06 left in the second period.
That's a tough break for Edmonton. They were right at the red line, just short. A lot of tired players out there. Just had a little bit of an extended shift, weren't able to get guys off. And now it's right back into your defensive zone.
Jay Woodcroft has done a great job with this team. It'll be his second full season. Had a half a year, did a good job in that first year, and then a full season last year where Edmonton in a thrilling series, round one, six games. They win it in Los Angeles. Game-winning goal, Kyler Yamamoto. And a six-game loss against Vegas in round two. Off the draw. They go to the corner. Wennberg now on Kemp. To the outside, Larson a keep. Adam Larson plays it deeper. Here's Wennberg. He'll dust it off. Alex Wennberg off a body, off Dineen, wedged right on, and Campbell right on the spot. Alex Wennberg in retrieval mode will pick up the puck as it pinballs around. A little chip there, and Jack Campbell continues to put on a show.
Tomorrow with Matty Beniers and Will Borgen. You'll see that soon on Inside Kraken Hockey, guys.
And Piper, you do a fantastic job with that show. That is so important for all of our fans, the ardent fans, the new fans, the young fans, and the old ones like me out of the corner. Lifted out through center ice. It's all part of the situation here on Root Sports. Total coverage of the Kraken, home and away. But we take you inside the game, too, which is vitally important. Out of the corner. Ryker Evans tied up by Zach Hyman. 5:27 left in the second period. A stick battle. Evans strong on the puck. Wills it out of the zone. CeCe feeds it back in for the Oilers. Larson with his head on a swivel is checked by McDavid. Everly with his back to the play. Evans still grinding, and Everly will get it out. This is Adam Larson. He'll defer out to Matty Beniers, who knocked it out of midair with great hand-eye. He'll get it deep. McCann goes to work on CeCe. It's left there. It kicks back. Dumoulin on a change. Evans with a shot blocked in front and covered by Campbell.
Well, Saturday did a good job in the defensive zone. Edmonton had a little bit of stuff going. They had McDavid. They had Drysdale moving the puck around. They're able to... All I gotta do is weather the storm. When those guys are out there, they get it into the offensive zone. Evans is able to get a good shot in. It does get blocked. But when you have their top guys out, you got to be able to just weather that storm.
Shane Wright wins the draw. Dumoulin shot off a bevy of humanity. A flinger on Campbell from the flank by Schultz. He gets it back. Campbell says no. Twice, three times. Wright and Cartier go to work. Dumoulin. Schultz swings it. Caught again by Jack Campbell. It's all him in the second period.
A lot of good looks for Seattle. You have to find yourself in the blue paint. Schultz throws one in. You got a chance there with Wright. Cartier gets a stick. Everybody's just going for that puck, but they're throwing pucks towards the front of the net, and you have to find your way and stop when you get to that blue paint.
Shane Wright and Brad Malone on this draw. And Malone has control. He'll take it back for Gleason. 4:30 left in the second period. Tied at one. It comes across. Malone moves in. He's defensively marked by Cartier, Bourgault. Diagonal pass, Desharnais. Popping out to it now is Griffith. He'll move it in. David Desharnais out of the corner, takes it back. Hounded by Dumoulin, Griffith, and now Gleason with a shot. No tip available, and it comes free to the wall. Griffith will send it in by Bourgault. Dumoulin on him, Schultz. Shane Wright, it's got to get out. It does not. And now it will. Schultz for Cartier. Moved along for Yamamoto. Schultz down Letty Wilkins' way. Goes high off the glass. Free to the corner now. Picked up. Gleason a quick up. Griffith in control over the line. Seth Griffith with a shot swallowed up by Grubauer. With 3:36 left in the second period.
Hasn't been a lot of action for Grubauer here in this second period. Not great at Matt, but I would assume that that's, according to the scoreboard, that's first shot that he's seen in the second period. 3:36 left. So that's a good job by Seattle. Obviously, they've been in their defensive zone, but they've been able to keep everything to the outside, clog up the middle, not allow those pucks to get through to Grubauer.
In the two games and counting that we've seen, shot suppression is there again for the Kraken, right? Not a lot of shots coming from the other side. They dominated Calgary in night number one. Same thing against Vancouver, albeit with the lineups the way they were. Younger crews coming in. But that being said, they were that way as a 5-on-5 team last year. Burakovsky off the back of the goal. Wenberg wheels it, but it's interrupted by Raphael Lavoie. A self-pass, Evans gets back, shakes off his man, he hog-ties Lavoie. Riker Evans will take a penalty. 2:56 left in the second period.
Well, Riker Evans gets put in a tough spot here. Lavoie chips it past, he doesn't have his speed going. He's fine right here. Good play, but as soon as he grabs around the neck area of Lavoie, spins him around, that's where you get the penalty. But Evans was in a tough spot. That puck was turned over. He's flat-footed. He's just got to get back. Again, it was just that last second. First, the initial battle is okay, but once you wrap that arm around the head, spin him around, there's the penalty.
Third power play for the Oilers. Grubauer off the draw, mops it up. A good steal here by Dylan Holloway. Gleason around the horn, McDavid. Then Gleason gets it back in the ring. Draisaitl. Grubauer reads the play and hangs on.
And this power play is going to have their looks. Pass through the seam. Draisaitl sitting outside the dot, pushed well out. Larson tries to get out, attempt to block, but again, Grubauer's there strong. It's got to be tough when you haven't seen a lot of action and then you're thrown into a power play situation for Edmonton. You're shorthanded. They're going to have a lot of clean looks compared to a 5-on-5 situation.
Draisaitl, McDavid, Hyman, Holloway, and Gleason. McDavid broken up. Larson got to it. Ty Cartier, 2-on-1 with Alexander Wenberg. Cartier, a shot, body save for Campbell. Dylan Holloway sends it back for Ben Gleason. Under 90 seconds on this manpower advantage. McDavid, Holloway moves in. A drop pass, Ben Gleason in control. He'll think twice. He's picked up by Alex Wenberg. Here's Draisaitl. He'll take it in. Leon Draisaitl. A seam pass broken up by Dumoulin. Leon Draisaitl gets it back, and now Gleason moves it across by Larson. McDavid's on it. Draisaitl forked high and wide. Holloway with under a minute left on the power play. He'll settle it. Draisaitl again in the skates of Dylan Holloway. Here's McDavid, a reverse hit on Dumoulin. To the point, Gleason, he'll walk it, shoot it. The tip attempt by Hyman doesn't work. Larson plays it beautifully. The big cat will get it out of trouble.
Penalty kill doing a good job clogging up the lanes, not allowing Edmonton to get as many clean looks as you would think they'd get, like they had all last season, being the number one power play.
Xavier Borgo has the Edmonton goal tonight. 20 seconds left on the power play. Borgo out of the corner. Griffith is there, 23 in the white sweater. Megna for Seattle, grinding. Big number 44 now, Beniers, right up the gut.
It's plays just like that when the puck gets along the dasher and the boards, and it squeaks up. Matty Beniers is the first one on it. It's not an Edmonton Oilers jersey. They're just outworking them right now.
Penalty is over. Three kills for the Kraken. 50 seconds left in the second period, tied at one. Broberg, indirect pass broken up. Megna off a stick, glove down by Malone. Lavoie moves in for a shot. Good play by Megna and Fleury converging on him. 35 seconds left in the second period. David Desharnais wipes it in. Derek Ryan let it go back. Brad Malone supporting him. 25 seconds left in the period. Malone along the kick plate. Back it goes for Desharnais. Ceci with a shot through a screen blocked. Schwartz moves it out. A penalty will be called here with Burakovsky taken down. I believe it's Desharnais. Interference will be the call. 10 and a fraction left in the second period.
Puck flipped up in through the neutral zone. Burakovsky trying to get around.
73 for Edmonton, that's a minor penalty for interference.
Interference call. Desharnais definitely not happy. Thinks Burakovsky went down a little bit easy on that play. You got 10.2 seconds. Enough time if you get a clean win here if you're Seattle.
And Beniers attempting to get the clean win. JT speaks about fourth power play. 9 seconds left. They get it. Schultz, Eberle. Broken up. Beniers. Defended well by Broberg at the horn. So 1:50 of power play time will carry over to period three. Philip Grubauer, he and his teammates kill off three Edmonton power plays here in the second period, so no scoring. Xavier Borgo scoring first for the Oilers in period one, answered on the power play by Seattle's Kyler Yamamoto. So 40 in the books here at Climate Pledge Arena. Edmonton, Seattle. Goal against, 7 shots on the target, 11 shots missed, and 7 were blocked, and a big part of it is a 21-year-old by the name of Ryker Evans.
He's got a tough task today. Yes, he's playing with Adam Larson, who's done this many times before and has been successful. But Connor McDavid getting speed, forcing him to the outside, using your partner. Bad break, gets back on the back check, stops the play right there, forcing him to dive and jump through. And right here, 2-on-1 opportunity, turns at the last second, just gets enough of this puck to deflect it, making so he's not able to get a clean shot in on net. Yes, it hasn't been a perfect game for Ryker Evans, but it has been a good game. He doesn't look like he's out of place when he's playing here against some of the best players in the world.
The Kraken have 2 preseason games left. We'll be in Abbotsford, British Columbia, AHL home of the Vancouver Canucks on Wednesday night. We'll be in Edmonton on Kong on Friday night. That'll wrap up the preseason. Opening night. Year number 3 for the Seattle Kraken in the National Hockey League. Tuesday, October 10th in Las Vegas against the defending Stanley Cup champions. A pair of 10s on the draw. Seattle's Beniers, Edmonton's Ryan. Third period underway. Kraken on the power play for 1:40. Vincent Desharnais in the box for Edmonton. Grubauer now puts it on a tee for Justin Schultz. He'll start to break out to center ice with 90 seconds left on the power play. The Kraken have a power play goal tonight from Kyler Yamamoto. Eberle goes deep. Ceci reads it. Good stick by Burakovsky. Brad Malone for the Oilers. Flung along and out by Jared McCann. Inadvertently all the way down to Grubauer. So 70 seconds left on this power play. Schultz slings it back now for Jordan Eberle. He'll steam through center. The Oilers four abreast at the line. Eberle goes wide of Ben Gleason. Andy Beniers in control. He'll lay it back for Justin Schultz. It's picked up by Dylan Holloway. Now Eberle holding onto it. Good pass for Burakovsky. Off the stick of Beniers out in front. Picked up at the last second by Phil Kemp. Burakovsky walks it. Delays. Creeps in further. Lays it back for Schultz. Now Eberle. Justin Schultz. Burakovsky. Eberle in front. Campbell stretches out. He's got it. With Beniers knocking on the door.
Well, I think that's Gleason on Beniers in front of the net. That stops a goal here. Right on the tape, he comes through. Great feed by Burakovsky over to Eberle. And that's Gleason with the defense on Matty Beniers right at the top of the blue paint here. Gets a stick through the legs. Knocks him down, and then you're just trying to fight and find for that puck. But a great feed across by Burakovsky and good patience by Eberle to find Matty.
Vincent Desharnais, 23 seconds left on his penalty. Schwartz with a shot blocked in front by Cam Dineen out of the corner. Yamamoto tries to pry it out for the Kraken. He's helped out by Alex Wenberg. Good play by Schwartz, but it's played outside the stripe as we see by Podorolski. Andrew Podorolski lays it back. It spindles around. Janmark wins a battle for the Oilers. Yamamoto back on him. They go deeper in the zone. Vincent Desharnais out of the box. It kicks around, and Podorolski gets it out through center ice. 2 minutes gone in this third period. John Forsland, JT Brown, Piper Shaw. Here in Seattle, the final home game of the preseason for the Kraken. Ty Cartier picked up. Shane Wright will get it out to the neutral zone. Ben Gleason takes over. With a tight turn, he'll lay it back for Vincent Desharnais through center. Rejected by Larson. Moved around. McDavid lurking for it. He's got it. Connor McDavid, now Desharnais. Moves it across for Gleason. Gleason throws on the brakes and headmans the puck for Lavoie. This is McDavid. Raphael Lavoie. McDavid in tight. Shielded a bit by Grubauer. Vincent Desharnais will saddle it down deep. Just about 3 minutes gone in this third period to the point. Gleason now. Connor McDavid with space. A shot. He scores! A stinger by Connor McDavid. In tight. 17-11 left in this third period. 2-1. Edmonton.
Well, players like Connor McDavid are going to get their opportunities. Puck doesn't get out at the blue line. McDavid walking right in, short ice. A little bit of a 3-on-2 break there. But McDavid, how quickly he's able to go head up, fire that puck right along the ice and beat Grubauer before he's able to get down and get that stick in position. Puck's close. You have those opportunities. It's right up at the blue line. Edmonton's able to keep that puck in, and it ends in the back of your net.
So the Oilers with their second lead of this game. Cody Ceci now out to center. Goes by Hyman Megna. Back out to center. Left there by Shore. Here's Yamamoto. He'll pull up. Lay it back for Cale Fleury. Fleury is shot. Stopped. No rebound. Given up by Campbell.
Well, perfectly timed by Fleury. Jumping up into the play. Podorowski is able to just delay enough, find that second wave of attack. That's another thing Seattle was very good at last year, is their defense jumping into the play, but not forcing it, finding that right timing and being able to get those good opportunities in on the opposing goaltenders.
Podorowski helped out off the draw by Yamamoto. Adam Ernie and Philip Broberg are on him. They jam. Moved along and back it goes. Dreisaitl moved out. Cody Ceci. Moved across for Hyman to the slot and escapes of Dreisaitl and forked wide, and now Cale Fleury will take over. Get it out to the center zone. Podorolski, Devin Shore with room. Good stick by Ceci. Played all the way around. Podorolski, Devin Shore down deep. In the skates of Andrew Podorolski, and now Leon Dreisaitl has it for Edmonton, and they're back out. Dreisaitl moves it around. Hyman pulls up. Lays it back for Dineen. Now Dreisaitl out of the corner. In the skates that time of the defender Dumoulin, and it comes out through center. Yamamoto will send it in. Phil Kemp 15:50 left in regulation time. 2-1 Edmonton, the go-ahead goal, Connor McDavid. Brad Malone off the boards. Dumoulin had it, lost it. Now Griffith. He'll play it all the way around. Justin Schultz for the Kraken. Moves the puck. Retrieved nicely by Beniers. Matty on the attack. He'll stick handle in. Rubbed out. Good play by Phil Kemp. Seth Griffith now through center. This is Cam Dineen. He'll feather it by Schultz. McCann to the corner. Hamblin on him. They jam for it. Malone is there too, along with Seattle's Schultz. They jam, and it's poked out. Griffith will get it to the point man, Vincent Desharnais. He'll slide it in. Brad Malone all the way around. A pinch by Ben Gleason. And the Kraken take over. Just about 5 minutes gone in this third period. Adam Larson. Shadowed on the way out by Matthias Janmark. Larson now looks over the breakout. Justin Schultz has been out there for a while. Larson moved by Wenberg and all the way back in for icing.
And he's not able to change there. Icing sends the puck back. You can see Schultz right now from up top. He's got his stick on his knees, hunched over a little bit. You can tell he's a bit tired. Key emphasis here, win the draw and make sure you get that puck 200 feet down. Maybe it's an icing, but that puck has got to leave the defensive zone for Seattle.
Schultz has been on the ice for a minute and 42 seconds. McDavid is second of preseason from Ben Gleason and Vincent Desharnais. At 2:49 has given the Oilers the lead off the draw. Out of the corner, Schultz now. Jaden Schwartz off a body. Wenberg had it, lost it. McDavid defers out. Dylan Holloway circles. Now Desharnais handcuffed a bit. Played to the outside. To the ring, Lavoie broken up. Raphael Lavoie lost his stick. Seattle buzzes out Burakovsky. Moving up on Gleason. The Kraken were offside. 14:18 left in this third period.
Well, close play there. Burakovsky pulls back just a tad, but I like the play by Jaden Schwartz going over the blue line. Uses his stick to try to get the defensemen's out of the way, that creating that little bit of lane, but it just drew him offside a tiny bit. Otherwise, you have a real good look with one of your best shooters on the team with open ice towards the middle.
Shane Wright, Kyler Yamamoto, and Ty Cartier come out for Seattle. Just about 6 minutes gone in this third period. Hyman now broken up. Cartier on the way back. Penetrates in. Good play by Broberg. Philip Broberg. It goes by him. Dreisaitl guts away. We see it up close. Right all over him. Cody Ceci moved out. Bodied down by Megna in the skates of Cartier. Kicks high and out of play. 13 minutes. 54 seconds left in regulation time here at Climate Pledge Arena. Connor McDavid, the most valuable player in the National Hockey League, has given Edmonton a 2-1 lead. John, JT, and Piper back with you. Here in Seattle Center, where the Kraken trail preseason game number 4, 2-1. A penalty here with Dreisaitl going down in the corner. It's a high sticking call. Check out his injury status. It appears to be none. Shane Wright will get 2 minutes for high sticking.
...51 for Seattle has a minor penalty for high sticking.
Well, on the backtrack is Shane Wright. It's not the first attempt, it's the second one. Right into the mouth of Dreisaitl. Definitely not intentional, but you have to have control of your stick. Going for the stick lift, ends up missing the stick, hitting the face, and you put a dangerous team back on the power play.
Leon Dreisaitl, Zach Hyman, Connor McDavid, Dylan Holloway, and Cam Dineen get out there for Jay Woodcroft and the Oilers. Wenberg, Cartier, Larson, and Dumoulin for Seattle. 13:37 left in this third period. Fourth power play for the Oilers. Leon Dreisaitl back on it. The Kraken get in defensive posture. Dreisaitl off a stick. Collected by Holloway. Picked off by Dumoulin. Hard out of the zone. 30 seconds killed by Seattle. Campbell puts it on the tee for Cam Dineen. Now it's quarterbacked out of the zone by Connor McDavid. His goal, the difference right now. McDavid throws on the brakes. It's loose, flung out. Megna clears it all the way down to Campbell.
Penalty kill did a good job squeezing up, not allowing a lot of space to get through when you cross the blue line, and that puck ends up getting all the way down, wasting another 15 to 20 seconds.
Dreisaitl for McDavid with a head of steam. He'll option off. Good play by Dreisaitl. Shot off a stick, frozen by Grubauer.
Well, nice play there by Dreisaitl. You can see the hands and the creativity at work, moving to the middle. See the drop off right there, a little nutmeg around McCann, and I think he's trying to go for a little shot there, but good sticks through the middle and allowing Grubauer to just cover that one up.
57 seconds left on this crack and kill. Lavoie will take the draw and lose it to Devin Shore. Riker Evans has time. Smartly, he'll dump it all the way down with 49 seconds left on this power play. 12:29 left in the third period. Kraken down by one. Seth Griffith knocked out of midair by Larson. A reset by the Oilers. Broberg for Ben Gleason. Near the center zone, Gleason now hits the line. Lays it along off the stick of Larson. Side of the goal. Borgo out in front. Broken up. Yamamoto outlets all the way down.
Well, nice job by Grubauer there getting to the other post. If he's lazy in that situation, Edmonton bringing that puck right back in. You got to be careful.
Zone entry by Griffith. Back it goes for Gleason. 9 seconds on the power play. Broberg. Gleason surveys. All the way across. Seth Griffith and back for Broberg. Lane taken away by Schwartz. The penalty has concluded. Broberg out of the corner. Borgo scores. Xavier Borgo, his second goal tonight. A one-timer from the dead slot. 11:39 left in the third period. 3-1, Edmonton.
Borgo finds himself in a dead area right around the dot. Great backhand pass here. You got Broberg, pulls it through all the way around. You're finding it's not going to be a power play goal for Edmonton. Shane Wright just entered the picture, but not enough to get back in the play. And it's just a soft area. Borgo did a real nice job finding that little lane in between Seattle's defense and is able to put that one past Philip Grubauer.
11:37 left now. Evans through center. Shots are 24 Seattle, 10 taken by the Oilers. Campbell moves it. The wall sealed by Jaden Schwartz. In pursuit is Wright. And it's cleared out by Broberg. James Hamblin moved along for Cody Ceci. His shot, stick save, Grubauer. Played to the boards. Burakovsky through center for Shane Wright. Ceci now pestered by Schwartz. Ceci stays true on the puck. Shane Wright there, 51 for the Kraken. And it's held in by Riker Evans. Andre Burakovsky checked by Cody Ceci. The Oilers in possession now. Janmark gets help from Hamblin, who's out through center. He'll feed it in. Bounces wide of Grubauer. 10:47 left. McCann gains the zone. Good stick. He gets it back. Stick save Campbell. As McCann had the opportunity, Eberle in back of the goal. He'll play it to the outside. McCann out of the corner. All the way back for Matty Beniers. To the outside, Cale Fleury. McCann, what a save! Jack Campbell with his best.
What a save by Campbell. Great pass across by Fleury to McCann. Player stick and all. Campbell's able to get that glove just outstretched far enough for McCann. McCann was not able to one-time that puck. It came with a lot of zip over from Fleury. Not completely flat either, but he was able to corral it. But that gives Campbell just a split second longer to get himself post-to-post and make that glove save.
Eberle in the circle now. Edmonton back out. Lavoie on the self-pass. Good play by Cale Fleury on him. Megna out of the corner. Fleury is pinned by Lavoie. Now Megna. 10-10 left in the third period. McCann, supported by Eberle, will shoot in on Campbell, who kicks it out with a purpose. Ben Gleason elevates the puck out. Justin Schultz now for Seattle. The quick up, Eberle dances in with Beniers. He'll circle away from Desharnais. Schultz off a stick off Eberle wide. McCann, nobody home out in front. Broken stick for Holloway. Vincent Desharnais back out to center. Broken up now. Eberle sends it back for Schultz. Quick up, finding Beniers. He'll pull up. Hattie now looks around. Dishes back Dumoulin. The pass doesn't click. Beniers out of the corner. Sends it low to high. Brian Dumoulin now. Beniers. He'll wind it in. Ty Cartier powers out. Off a body, off Campbell, off Gleason, and back out. 9:20 left in regulation time. Andrew Podorolski in control. Through center, read by Broberg. James Hamblin moves it to the boards and back in. Larson. Yamamoto steers out to center. This is Ty Cartier, defended by Cody Ceci. Andrew Podorolski for Seattle. Some driftwood on the ice. You see the broken stick. Podorolski now. Cartier in front. Yamamoto slam denied by Campbell. Podorolski tries the other side. Good stick by Griffith. Not out though. Evans will trap the zone. Yamamoto goes to work. He's tugged by Malone. They play on. Griffith back out to center ice. 8:37 left as Edmonton changes on the fly.
Well, great offensive shift there. We talk a lot about trying to have that close support. You have a little triangle offense there. They're able to find the inside to get a nice one-timer look for Yamamoto.
Renberg from Schwartz and the slopper. Akovsky, good block by Cam Dineen. Schwartz denied and covered by Campbell. The chances are plentiful tonight for the Seattle Kraken. A 36, Jack Campbell, the veteran goaltender. He's been stellar. And the Oilers have a two-goal lead.
Opportunities, but Campbell's been there every step of the way. Big-time saves like the one we just saw right there. Again, he's a big reason why Edmonton has a 3-1 lead. It could be completely different. He's having himself a game.
He really is. Off the draw, Wenberg advances a power move out in front. Shut down. Lower portion taken away by Campbell. Penalty upcoming against Edmonton. As they touch up, it was knocked down in front that time by Phil Kemp. 8:08 left in regulation. The Kraken back to work on the power play.
76 Edmonton has a minor penalty for slashing.
Slashing on Phil Kemp.
This whole play is made by driving the puck to the net. Don't take the easy way from below. He could definitely go around the net. Wenberg decides to drive that puck to the inside, and that's where you get Kemp taking the penalty. If he goes around, there's no penalty.
McCracken are 1-for-4 with their power play tonight. 12 minutes gone, third period play. John, JT, and Piper with you. Schultz moves it back for Jordan Eberle. The Oilers stack it up. And self-pass by Eberle. CeCe out of the corner. Burakovsky there for the Kraken. They grind. Janmark, 13 in the white sweater, attempting to pry it out. McCann for Schultz. Calling for it, Beniers. To the line, Eberle. Matty Beniers. Schultz. Burakovsky off the side of the goal. Helped by Campbell. Malone hard-pressed. A buck 17 left in this power play. Right on the spot, Matthias Janmark will kill some time. The Oilers roll a change.
Well, good shooting mentality. You get that puck over to your shooter on the one-timer side with Burakovsky. Going to see a lot of that throughout the year here with Seattle on the power play. One-timer ready to rock.
Yamamoto moves up, drops it off for Evans. He's broken up by Adam Ernie. Then he recovers nicely, but Ernie kills more time. 45 seconds left in the power play. 6:50 left in this third period, 3-1 Edmonton. Riker Evans for Kyler Yamamoto. He'll gain the zone, defer out. Podorolski carries in. Evans at the point, swings it. Here's Wenberg. Riker Evans. Podorolski to the line. Yamamoto in front. Wenberg, back it goes. Evans again, Podorolski. Here it comes, tipped high, and it goes out of play.
Well, heavy shot there from Podorolski. I thought they had an opportunity prior to get the puck towards the net. It works itself back around. Evans over to Podorolski. Gets all of that shot before up and out of play. Not sure what that deflected off of, But you can see there, he had a good opportunity, plenty of time to let that one rip.
17 seconds left in this power play. Time enough should they win the draw. But the Oilers will hunt it down. Derek Ryan out of the corner, pressed by Eberle. Brad Malone held in. McCann cradling it. Schultz. Here's Burakovsky with a shot shielded off the stick of Campbell and back out. That'll do it. Kemp's out of the box. The Oilers kill it. 14 minutes gone in this third period. Kraken down by two. Cody Ceci with a steal. Seth Griffith and now Zach Hyman. Pushed off the puck by Brian Dumoulin. Hyman attempting to get it back. He had a career season last year with Edmonton in terms of goal scoring. Now Griffith over the line. Leon Draisaitl defensively marked by Schultz. Justin Schultz has the puck. Seattle's back out. Devin Shore through the middle for Shane Wright. He'll send it in. Broberg is back. Philip Broberg to the outside. Left along the boards. Ty Cartier for Seattle. Pops out, shoots it. A headhunter held in this way by Larson. Larson cycling out as Shore off Draisaitl. And now Broberg sends it along. 5:15 left. Phil Kemp not out. Brian Dumoulin for the Kraken. All the way around. Philip Broberg will get it, move it. And Larson has it in the center zone. Just about 15 minutes gone in this third period. 30 shots for the Kraken. 11 shots on goal by Edmonton. Ben Gleason, these two teams will play with different looking lineups. Probably a dress rehearsal on Friday night in Edmonton. For the final time in preseason, McDavid moved across. Gleason through the middle. Ben Gleason penetrates off the glove hand of Grubauer. Lavoie moves it in. 4:37 left. Here's McDavid. Connor McDavid out of the corner. Pops it out. Lavoie stick handling. Paddle down and a cover for Philip Grubauer. 4 minutes and 31 seconds left in regular.
Supporting underserved and underrepresented children. And also a big congrats to Alex and Felicia. They shared last week that they are expecting their second child in the spring. John.
Oh, great news. Fleury now to the outside. Back out to center. Ben Gleason. Deep in his own territory. 4:20 left in this third period. The Oilers with a two-goal lead. Connor McDavid. And Ben Gleason now will work it out. The Beniers line is out there for Seattle. Megna goes deep in his own zone. Forecheck by Lavoie. Cale Fleury. A steal. Holloway off sticks. And McDavid will hunt it down. Connor peels away from Eberle. Stolen by Schwartz. A deal back for Megna. And a reset. Both teams are changing. The Wenberg line gets out there for Dave Hakstol. Wenberg, Schwartz, and Yamamoto this time. It's dumped in. Ceci, Broberg by Borgo, and it comes out to center. Borgo has two goals tonight. Xavier Borgo, the former first-round pick of the Edmonton Oilers, now goes by Yamamoto. Campbell, who played himself, 3:20 left. Janmark pinching down Larson, and it comes out through center. Brian Dumoulin, ahead of Borgo, will take it back. Adam Larson now rethinks it for Seattle. Both teams change once again. Just about 17 minutes gone in this third period. Cartier will feed it in. Cam Dineen for Philip Broberg. On the wall, Ernie is tied up by Wright. And the Oilers get it out. We'll keep an eye on Grubauer. 2:50 left. Philip Grubauer swings the puck for Cale Fleury, who's double-teamed, but he survives it. Paul Orlsky. Cartier sidesteps Kemp. Puck is there for the taking, settled down by Draisaitl, and now Cam Dineen plays it off the boards. Adam Ernie steered along by Grubauer. Paul Orlsky looks up the ice. He'll zing it by McCann, who's crunched by Kemp, icing Seattle.
Seattle not able to get that puck into the offensive zone. A lot of play through the neutral zone. Not allowing Grubauer to get out, get that extra attacker. Still plenty of time left here in this game. You've had a lot of good opportunities and good looks, especially if you can get that extra attacker, get Grubauer to the bench. But you got to get that puck all the way in past that red line, dump it in, and get on the forecheck.
2:27 left in this third period. McDavid wins the draw for Cam Dineen. He'll move it across for Kemp. He'll keep it to the outside. Stopping and starting is McDavid out in front off the back of the goal. Dylan Holloway in control. He'll wind it up. Now Phil Kemp Cross ice. It goes by Dineen out of the corner. 2:10 on the clock. Going down in a hard way that time was Dineen, hit by Fleury. A shot taken that time goes high off the stick of Dylan Holloway. This is McDavid. Holloway with a shot right over Grubauer again. A 1:55 left. Dineen at the point. Cam Dineen moves it back, gets it back from Holloway. And he's greeted there by Seattle's McCann. McCracken desperately tried to get it out to center with 1:43 left, down by a couple. Eberle goes to work. Grubauer takes a look at the bench. The stop sign is up for now. Riker Evanson control, 90 seconds left. Here's Matty Beniers, and there goes Grubauer. Cross ice pass for Evans. He's in the zone. It's picked up by Vincent Desharnais, and it's steered out through center and all the way back. It'll spindle, and it doesn't make it. No icing. Burakovsky will leave it there for Schultz. 1:15 on the clock. Seattle down by two. This is Matty Beniers. He attempts to gain center. He'll deal it back for Riker Evans. 30 shots for the Kraken and 13 taken by the Oilers. Eberle in front. Schwartz picked up. Schultz moves in. Vincent Desharnais took a swing at it. It goes off Campbell. Desharnais is pressed. It's rolled around. Burakovsky gets to it. Now Jaden Schwartz. 47 seconds left. Burakovsky carries in, pestered by Janmark. All the way across, just by Schultz on the back door. Schwartz will keep it there. Eberle out of the corner. A throw on the brakes away from Dreisaitl. 32 seconds left. Here's Evans with a shot patted down by Campbell. Hyman gets it out. No, he didn't. It's held in by Evans. 23 seconds left. Six skaters out for the Kraken. Beniers, Burakovsky to the line. Good stick by Ben Gleason. Beniers checked hard by Gleason. 12 seconds left. Janmark has control. He'll carry out with a yawning Cage. He hits it. Matthias Janmark hits the mark. 4-1, Edmonton.
Seattle 6-on-5 unit did get some time. They were able to get the puck in the zone possession. Get a few pucks towards net, but Edmonton's able to win a quick battle here. As soon as he gets the red line, decides to fire that one off the post and in to the net. There's the 4-1 for Edmonton, but again, this is all about getting extra looks, getting your practice. It is the preseason. It's not a regular season game. You want to see those looks. You want to see what teams are doing and how your team does.
These two teams will have a rematch on Friday night. Time expires. The Edmonton Oilers pick up their third win of the preseason. Dave Hextall's team has two games remaining on the preseason schedule. We will have a shootout tonight just for rehearsal sake. And we'll take a look at what has transpired here tonight, with Edmonton scoring first, his first of two for young Xavier Bourgault.
A good 3-on-2 rush here off the blocker of Grubauer, and able to just find a nice little soft area, backhands it past Grubauer into an empty cage. I like this power play look. Quick over, shot tip into the middle. Schwartz is able to get it onto the net, but it's Yamamoto who finishes the puck past Campbell. You continue on into the third period. Puck does not get out of the zone here, and it's McDavid. He's going to have his opportunities throughout the game. Slides this one 5-hole, quickly past Grubauer. Not a whole lot there. I mean, McDavid's going to have his chances. They did a great job keeping him somewhat in check, but it's almost impossible to keep McDavid fully in check. And you're going to see right here in the slot, last one right, almost a power play type goal. Right, just got onto the ice, finding that soft area. He did that twice for two goals, finding little soft areas and getting it past Grubauer.
So a look ahead Wednesday night, Abbotsford, British Columbia, as the Kraken take on the Vancouver Canucks for the second time in preseason. The finale will be Friday in Edmonton on Kong. Regular season kicks off with the Vegas Golden Knights, nationally televised on ESPN Tuesday the 10th. And our first game here on Root Sports will be in Music City on the 12th. So Jack Campbell will take a look at Matty Beniers, who will be shooter number one for the Kraken in the shootout. And Beniers scores. Beautiful move.
Very similar to a move we saw him do this morning at pregame skate. pulls it to the backhand, stops, goes back forehand. Campbell's not able to stop his momentum quick enough, and he's able to go post and in past Campbell.
Connor McDavid with a goal tonight in regulation. He'll take a wide angle, a stare down with Grubauer. And Grubauer gets the paddle down.
Well, good timing there for Grubauer against McDavid. You can see right away, head up the whole way. McDavid's just looking, trying to find that opening. Quick to the forehand side. Grubby's blocker, not able to quite lift it up over the top or underneath the blocker, right into the middle.
Jared McCann, we'll get some shootout practice in here. But stop by Campbell, who played really well tonight.
Well, I like the change of pace here. McCann dials up a little bit of speed, comes in quickly, tries to do a quick snapshot, blocker side. Campbell's able to get just a piece of it, but I like the change of pace. Not everyone has to be a slow.
Leon Draisaitl makes it look easy. And the shootout is tied at one.
Well, there's another slow attempt here. Draisaitl coming in, head up all the way. Think he's going to go backhand, but how quickly he goes from that backhand to forehand and around the right pad of Grubauer.
He started his career as a first-round pick of the Edmonton Oilers, and Jordan Eberle closing in on 1,000 games this season will be the third shooter. Old school stand-up stop by Jack Campbell.
I think Eberle just missed his shot here on this play. Coming in, you see him go wide to that forehand side. He wants to snap that one up over the shoulder. Just wasn't able to get enough of it. Ends up hitting Jack Campbell towards the midsection.
Adam Ernie can win it for the Oilers in the shootout for practice purposes. And he does. Adam Ernie. That's the second one by Philip Grubauer. So the Oilers take home the game 4-1 and the shootout 2-1.
Well, good move here by Ernie. Backhand, forehand, quickly, but it's how quick he snaps it afterwards up over the top of Grubauer's glove and into the back of the net. Sorry, his blocker and into the back of the net.
So the Kraken with two more. It'll be a young lineup, we assume, on Wednesday night, and then the dress rehearsal on Friday.
And you can take a lot of good things from this game into the next two. You got to think at the end of the day, you're going to win more games if you play like this than you're going to lose. You look at the shot totals, scoring chances. Edmonton was very opportunistic today.
We'll be with you on Kong Friday night from Edmonton. For JT Brown, Piper Shaw, and our great crew here at Climate Pledge Arena. Final score, Edmonton Oilers 4, the Seattle Kraken 1. This is John Forslund. Good night, everybody.
Jersey Mike's, they freshly grill your hot subs right in front of you. You can't get that smell anywhere else unless you have one of these.
Don't mind me. Take the sizzle to go.
Grill right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing.
Those new tiles are falling right into place until you run out of, what are those called again? Oh, right. The Home Depot app is made for doing that doesn't miss a beat. So you can find what you need fast and keep things moving in the right direction. For doing that doesn't stop, download the Home Depot app. It's made for doing.
Target Circle Week, here now through October 7th with Target Circle member-only deals. Save on toys you want, groceries you need, styles you love, and so much more. Don't miss out on Target Circle Week. Join now for free at Target.com to start saving.
Ford. You see the name driving down almost every road in America. But you'll also find it in other places. On the grip of hammers raising homes, in toy boxes, and classrooms. Because over 2,900 Ford dealerships nationwide means more people serving more communities like yours. For more than 120 years. Ford. We are all in on America.
Signs help us navigate our world. Signs keep us on course, headed in the right direction, excited about upcoming events, and punctuate important moments in our lives. Signs build brands, create connections, and define purpose. Signs speak with strength to communities, guests, clients, and customers. Signs create impact and grab attention like no other medium can. For over three decades with locations throughout the world, Signorama is the way to grow your business.